You guessed it, Rule King 2.0. We're fixing to go in there and we're fixing to see what they got for deals today, people. So follow me and let's see what's up. I'm here in Pennsylvania, where the Rural Kings are made a little smaller, but not as small as you'd think, let's say, if you know what I mean. So right off the bat, I smell some kind of barbecue. They're making something in here. But let's take a look at the situation and you tell me what you think. Well, they got the nice music playing. Looks like they got a boot sale going on here. Let's see what they get for these Ariats. Huh, don't see a price. Oh, wait a minute, here we go. $179. That's not too bad. They feel a little light in the loafers, if you know what I mean. Oh, there we go. Now, I like that. How much are those bad boys? Not bad. Okay. Let's take a little walk through the other area here. See if they got... I like the Red Wings myself. But I don't see the Red Wings situation here. Double M brand. Yep, we're over to the big old Rural King and PA. We're trying to see exactly... how do I put this? If we got any sales or deals that we might be driving by the highway, and the situation says you might be making a mistake by not actually seeing what's on sale. Here we are in the fishing department. Oh no, we hit the jackpot, people. That's what I'm talking about. We definitely are in my section. I like to see some of this stuff they got here. They got ammo cans. Oh, look at this. 30 rounders, $17.99. That's not a bad deal. That's $9 for a standard magazine, 5.56. That's a 30 rounder. They do have some good deals. I can see this already. I got pictures of the wildlife up there. I mean, if you don't like a Rural King in your area, if you actually like a Rural King, and you'd say, I wouldn't mind having a Rural King in my area, I don't have one exactly where I live. I think I want to write them and tell them, come up on in my area with a Rural King, because they got some good deals. Like 2 times more durable. $30, that's a good deal. I'd like to know what size them are. And them are Ariat. Now, I know these jeans are good. I want to see what size they are. 33 long. No, that ain't gonna work for me. That's the clearance rack, though. That's the clearance rack. Huh. They got some decent stuff in here, though. Oh, they got a Bowen compound bows. This is your standard equipment right here if you're out hunting in Pennsylvania, I can tell you right now. Them are some nice, those are nice arrows for $20. Get 3 of them. And they got the food processing area. It's pretty nice. I tell you, these Rural Kings are pretty good. I got me a smaller one of this version right here. Not that brand, but boy, that's a nice bag right there. For $24.99, that's a good deal. I like this one here, this little Playmate cooler. The only problem with these is they don't seem to hold ice that long. You'd almost be better off with an Igloo one like this. They got all your RV stuff. For all you RVers out there, if you know what I mean. Trying to be a camper special, you got it right here. That's the type of camping we're not going to do in a tent. We're not doing the pop-up tent. $119 for the pop-up tent. Nope, ain't going to happen. Now this is my stuff right here. This is my style. A little lodge cooking equipment. I mean, look at this one here. You could make some serious food with this big pan right here. That's a cast iron dual pan handle. 17 inch. That's pretty nice. And this one has this double handles. This one has just one handle. And that one's $50 for this one. Let's see what this one is. This one's $69. At the Rural King, $69. I might have to go home with that. That's a nice one there. You get you some sausage and some potatoes and onions and garlic put in there. And you let that baby simmer. And I'll tell you right now, you ain't never going to go wrong with a Dutch oven. Wow, I got a couple of these. $99 now. Whew, man. $109 for the one you do outside. See that with the square lid? A little lip on it. I got a couple of those too. Man, I bought things when the buying was right, I think. This Biden economy, let me tell you. This ain't for the squeamish at heart, if you know what I'm saying. Now here we go. We've got some, we're headed over into the Farm and Livestock Center, and we're going to see what they've got for equipment over here. Now look at these things that you got for like all your outdoor wash tubs. Okay. You've got all the, oh, look at this. You got these little signs. Area patrolled by attack chicken. Boy, you ain't never lied. I see a couple of them chickens. I was working at a fella's house, and he turned around and had these chickens. The rooster, whoever it was very protective. He did not want me doing what I had to do at their house for that day. Now look at this. They have got the gate situation on lock. They got the max air fan blowing, keeping everything circulating. But look what they've got here. Now I'd love to have a couple of these. Wow. Maybe I wouldn't love it. $244. That's for the gate. That's a big gate. It looks like about a 16 footer. Now this ain't a bad deal. $122. You could deal with that if you made like a little shelter and put them up. You could even put a small frame up, a small top for those and put some equipment under those. Now that's not a bad deal. I wouldn't mind having about 8 of these, and they interlock in the corners right here. Now that's a good deal. They got the pens, the big pen, the galvanized one. They got the painted one. And look at this, they've even got the round arches for making the pens. They got the big tubs for the water. There's a lot of things you can do with those galvanized tubs. You can make like little water faucet things with them, where you have like a water fountain in your yard. This one here, I think, is for round bales. I think that's if you had like a round bale and you wanted the cattle to eat off of it. You just put the round bale or two in there. Because them things are heavy. Them round bales are pretty heavy. I think they're around 1,000 pounds, to be honest with you. And this is here another setup where you can throw some hay or whatever in there and let your goats or your cattle eat from it. I mean, I really don't know. I'm just saying I think that's what they use them for. And of course, you got all your implements and all your hitches and pins. I know you guys want to look at all this. This is what we look at. This is part of the guy code, right? If you can walk, let me give you a little update. Situation that I figured out. If you think yourself, okay, let me guess. Am I a transgender? You don't know that, right? You say to yourself, you're confused. You were born after 1989, and you're saying to yourself, am I a transgender, or am I a situation that says, I'm whatever my sexual organs are, that's who I really am? If you don't know if you're a transgender, you, the DIYer, don't know. The only thing you have to do is go to a Rural King, and you have to walk by this hitch pin area, and clevis, and all these other implement pieces. If you can walk by without even batting an eye, and you just keep on moving, you're a female. It doesn't matter what you have for sexual organs, don't matter about your chromosomes, it doesn't matter if you're XX or YX, it doesn't matter. If you can walk by this stuff right here, and not even bat an eye, looking at these pins, looking at these hitches, clevises, if you can walk by all this, then you're definitely a female. If you have to, it's just like a passage for men. You have to, if you know when you walk by here, you want to come take a look at this stuff, even though you've seen it 1,000 times, that's a true indicator of what you definitely are. Because if you're a man, you're going to say, I got to go check that out. You might even get yelled at if you've got another fellow with you that might be, say he's identifying as a female, and you thought, well, I thought this guy was a guy. And he walks on by and says, man, you're ridiculous. I can't believe you're going to look at them hitches. And he starts whining and complaining and saying, we got to get home. All this stuff that you would typically hear from a female. If you listen to someone like that, then you know that they're a transgender. And there's no shame in that. It's just letting you know that the person you're with, he doesn't identify as a male. Because you can't walk by a set of gears and cogs and not come look at them if you're a female. Excuse me, if you're a male, see, I'm getting even confused here. I don't understand it, but that's just how it works. It just pulls you in. If you're a male and you're really, truly a male, then this brings you over to this area and says, I got to take a look at these again, even though you've seen them 1,000 times. So don't worry about it. All you got to do is go to a Rural King and take a look at the hitches and pins and all this other stuff, and you'll definitely be... It will bring clarity to you, right? You'll be able to say, I know exactly what I am. It doesn't matter what the situation says about it. I know what I am. And then you'll know because you couldn't walk by. You had to go put your hands on the equipment and say, I'm a man. So here we are. We're walking over into, it looks like the little chick area. Let's take a look. We got to look at these, right? Rural King chicks. And we're not talking about the Dixie chicks. Oh, look at that. Those are pretty cool right there. I guess that's a white turkey, from what I understand from by the sign. So that's white turkey. These ones here, and it says it's a brown pullets, whatever that means. It must be a type of chicken. Man, they got all these different colors. They got guineas. Looks like they're trying to sleep. They're not trying to hear it. Wow. That's where your next chicken nuggets are coming from, people. I know you don't want to hear it, but that's why they call them chicken nuggets, if you didn't know. Yep, that's about the size of a chicken nugget. And then you got, of course, you got your dog food. What else? Oh, look at this. They got rabbits. The Rural King's got a little bit of everything now. That black one's saying it's time for bed now. They're pretty cool. They're pretty cool. They're all by themselves, just hanging out in the corner. Of course, now I wouldn't mind having a couple of these buckets right here. These big, tough stuff products. I like those. That one right there would be nice to have in a garage for just for a little bit of everything. It's got a little lid on it. I guess you'd put your dog food in it. Of course, they got the big muck tubs. Now, what is this? Holy cow, I don't know what that is. That's some kind of big bucket. These are like a feeder, a mineral feeder for the deer. Oh, a salt block feeder, yeah. They got a little bit of everything. Now, I know they're not thinking that they would use it for this, but I would use this for an oil pan. Now, this one right here is a type of pan that you'd put out for, let's see what it says. Galvanized hog, something hog pen utility. But I would use that for even for oil. And they got the plastic version, of course. They got a lot of nice stuff here at the Rural King. This one here I like with the double handle. But looks like they got the baby pig feeder. I don't know what they're going to eat out of that, but I definitely like the situation. It has all the different buckets, all the different tubs. And let's see what else they've got in here. Oh, this is that. This ain't just regular baling twine now, people. Hold on. This is premium baling twine. I'm going to tell you something. If you know anything about baling twine, it ain't just your run-of-the-mill. This is the stuff that doesn't get hung up in your baler. Okay, people? And of course, look at this. They've got all the... not really a bad price now for all the wood shavings and chips. $5.59. That's your standard chips right there. I think the other ones are... I think the other ones have the... they're the cedar smell or cedar chips themselves. But they've got the animal traps. I see they've got some chairs. They got a little bit of everything here at the Rural King, people. And I don't know if we're going to be able to see a lot because it's towards the end of the night. And the situation says we've already seen quite a little bit, but how do I put it? They got the music playing. And then, of course, they've got, looks like the dog cat food section over here, which you already know what all that stuff's all about. And now we're getting into the stuff that says this is more, looks like gardening, mason jars, okay? I'll tell you what, I'm going to write Rural King and ask them to put one in upstate New York where I'm from. I wouldn't mind having one, actually. I would even be a sponsor. I would be a sponsor of Rural King. I would go around all the stores and show all the, highlight all the areas that they are doing well in and maybe highlight all the areas that they could use some improvement in. But from what I see, they don't need much improvement, people. They've got a little area here for like, I don't know what it's called. It's like all the little items you might need. They've got LED shop lights. Now, this ain't a bad deal. Now, Harbor Freight would have to say, that's something that they got to even compete with the Rural King. 6,000 lumens, $19.99. Was $24.99. Well, that's a pretty nice little situation right there. Oh, look at this. They got a welding area. You know we want... because we know how we identify. All right. The other thing is... now, these are good gloves. I'm going to tell you right now. I'm not... Hobart doesn't sponsor me. But I'm going to tell you right now. To stay on Laurel Drive. I've got the GPS in the background. But these right here are nice gloves. Now, I don't know if I want to cut loose with $29.99 tonight. But these are nice. But look at this. Now, they come with a carabiner. How many set of gloves you know come with a carabiner? You can put that on for your all your keys or something like that or whatever, you know. They got all the spool guns. What's they want for a spool? Wow, I should have bought a spool gun years ago. I could get one for $129 a Hobart. Now it's $269. Well, don't you blame Hobart. That's not their fault. This is the economy of Joe Biden right now. So, of course, they're going to be more expensive. Now, I noticed Hobart went with a different color scheme. I'm seeing this. Unless this is just for Rural King. That's kind of a little bit different. The color scheme here for the Hobarts. They usually come with a situation that... oh, look at this. Hold on. We got to stop what we're doing, people. We got something, someone that's wanted here in connection with an incident. 10/27/21. We got a couple clowns that must have been in the store doing something. Look at that. You see them, people? Wanted by police in connection with something, an incident. They don't tell you what the incident is, but I'll tell you right now, if you know them people, get on a horn with the people of PA, the state police, and let them know that you know who they are. And if you're out there watching this video and that's you on it, we're on to you, okay? We're on to you. We're not gonna wait much longer. We're on to you. We're just letting you think you got away with it. And it ain't going to be long. The long arm of the law, okay? The Kansas City law dog is coming for you, okay? Don't you rest easy. You better keep looking over your shoulder because at the end of the day, you're not going to steal from the Rural King, people. The Rural King is not going to have it, okay? But they got some beautiful stuff here, people. They've got some really, really nice stuff. And I'll tell you something I've never seen before. You see these little square goggles. Look at these ones. Now, that's something I wouldn't mind having for my plasma cutter. for $29.99, I think I could cut loose with that. I'll tell you right now, I wish I had a Rural King name near me. They got all the leather for the welding. You throw them on, it keeps the sparks, and even plasma cutting, that would keep all the hot embers at bay. As you see, they got stacks of them square ones. And they're just an uncomfortable set of goggles, but I bet you them round ones. Now, you ain't going to get away with wearing them and not being able to say, hey, the situation is these are comfortable. They got all the torches. Here's another gender reveal. If you can walk by these torches right here and not even bat an eye at it, you're female. If you can walk by these and say, it draws you in like a moth to a flame, then you're definitely a man, okay? And these are the ones I really like right here with the long reach right here. Those are nice. They got the hose. I got one of these. I want to see how much they get for this. It's got the holster and everything, right? $69. That's what I paid recently at a Lowe's. That's not a bad deal. That Burns-O-Matic one, that is the best one. It comes with like a 4-foot hose that connects to what my choice is, a map gas. I'm not sure what this red one is. Let's take a look at this. I think this is oxygen, to be honest with you. Yeah, I think you add this one. Oh, yep, it's oxygen. See it? There's a two set. You can put oxygen and propane that kind of gives you like a hotter flame. But the map gas right out of the gate is hotter. That's what I usually use for soldering and doing other things. But now here we are walking down through the steel aisle. Remember what I told you, people? Do you remember what I told you? When you go by the tractor supplies and they throw them skids out, you're getting multiple pieces like this, right? This little angle iron, this is nothing, okay? But look what they get for these little pieces of nothing. You see why I grabbed that free steel at Tractor Supply and I bring them home? Let me zoom in on this so you can see what I'm talking about. Multiple pieces, probably 15, 20 pieces on one skid. You do the math, okay? I'm here to be able to show you the deals, okay, of how to get the deals. But while I am here showing you at Rural King, you're going to need to pay attention now. You're going to need to say, this is a review of the Rural King 2.0, and we're not stopping here. We got to keep moving, okay? They got the Blue Clean set up here for the power washers. Oh, wait a minute now. Hold up now. Got vices. Now, let me tell you something. Don't just judge these vices. Look at this one right here. I wouldn't mind getting a smaller one like this for my bench because I got the big one, okay? But this little small one right here is really, really handy for doing like stuff that, how do I put it, that you don't really need a huge vise for. These little small ones right here are pretty handy. And actually, if I must say, they're marked pretty good, reasonable price for these. Now, this is a bigger one. This is like a 6-jaw. It is a 6-inch. I turn around and got a 6-inch on my vise. If you go back in my videos, you can see the vise that I got was about this size. I think I got it on clearance at Runnings. Another store, it's called Runnings, and I think I paid $79 because it was on clearance. But look at this. Look at this little crimson right here, this little anvil. Now, that's not a bad deal, people. Take a look at that. It's got a little hardy hole and a Pritchell hole. That's pretty handy. I got to say, for the cheaper of the anvils, that ain't a bad one. For $50, you could get basically do a lot of little handy stuff with that. You could carry that with you in your truck. And you'd be in good shape, you know. And I might even, I've got a big anvil, but I might even buy that just for carrying with me on jobs. You know, when you need to pound on something and there's nothing available. That's not a bad little setup right there. I mean, you take a look at it, the size of my hand. That's pretty nice little anvil. Okay. That's pretty nice. I might have to grab that before I go back home. And they've got all the clamps and all the cold chisels and hammers, okay? This is the stuff right here. I call this stuff right here a must-haves, okay? If you've got a man, you want to say to yourself, what do I get him for his birthday? What do I get him for Father's Day? You're looking at it, people. This is all the stuff that we like as men. Now, this is something I might have to buy before I leave. A little quarter-inch drive setup for putting my sockets on. Because let me tell you something about these. Let's take a little diversion here to these people at the TSA. The TSA, where the people that work at the TSA, you're sort of like the how do I put this? You're like the FBI in a way. You're crooked as hell, okay? And but not all of you, okay? There might be one or two of you that say to yourself, I like to be, you know, honest John. I like to do things correctly by the book. But you've got the lion's share of you are breaking people's shit, and you're turning around and stealing a socket or a wrench out of your box. You're saying to yourself, you feel like you go through and rifle through people's luggage with impunity. But really, in all reality, you're just like the FBI. You're almost, in a way, you're almost saying to yourself, you think you're getting away with it, but eventually, you're not going to get away with it, okay? So stop doing that to people's luggage and equipment that they work hard for. Because you're just an agency that really nobody in America even likes. You know, no one likes someone that goes through their stuff and rifles through it. And nobody likes the FBI lying and being crooked the way they've been being. So, the other thing, let's get back to the Rural King. Let's get off of the political rant and the rant that says we really don't appreciate some of the people in society, the top cops. They say, oh, the... it's not all of them, people. It's not all of the FBI. It's only the upper part. And that's another thing. You ever hear Sean Hannity? Oh, it's only the upper part of the FBI that's being bad. Oh, really? Oh, really? Why is it then that all the people that took an oath that don't say nothing, that don't stand up and become a whistleblower, when they're taking people's rights and they're stripping them of their rights and doing things crooked like spying on people and doing other things? If you condone it, if you're in the FBI and you've watched it and see it, you're just as guilty if you don't say something. Because you have a higher oath to the Constitution of America before you have a higher oath to, let's just say, the James Comeys or any of these other clown acts that work there. So anyway, let's get off that rant. Let's get back to the gender reveal at the King, Rural King. If you can walk by the weed eater section... This is something right here. These little chainsaw extended poles. I don't know what it is, but this is like, again, a fly being drawn right into, or a moth, let's say, being drawn into a flame or a light. If you're a man, you're going to be drawn into this stuff. Okay, we're going to get to the women, what they get drawn into in a minute. Okay, but right here, when you see this type of stuff, these little chainsaw, you don't even have to have a chain on it. You just see these bars and you automatically come over and want to look at them again. Even though you've seen them 1,000 times, you know what's up when you see these chains and bar sales. Okay? You already know who you are. You understand what the situation says. And now here you go. Let's talk about what the women are drawn into. When you see this watering, look at that. They even got a picture of a traditional woman on there. Look at that. She's hauling that little water jug, 5-gallon spot sprayer. She wants her garden to be right, and she's not trying to let... her man in there, because what he would do is turn it into a construction project when she really just wants to jumpstart her garden. Okay? She wants to jumpstart her garden, and here's the other thing she wants to do. She wants these wagon wheels. Okay? If you see these wagon wheels and you come running right over here, you're female. Let's just get the gender stuff out of the way, people. If you see these pots right here, this is all the stuff that would beautify your property. This is a traditional role of a female. They want to beautify their home. Okay, the man might build the home or get the home, but the woman's going to make it a home, if you know what I'm saying. These are the things right here that women love, and they definitely love this. 10% sales, they love on all planners when you see a 10% sale, and with this sign, the arrow of the dollar sign going downward, women love that stuff. They love that stuff. Okay, here you go. You're over here now. You're back into the area of some what I call, this would be called maybe like a situation where you really couldn't say either way. When you get into honey.com and stuff like this, real honey, both people like that. Okay, vacuum sealers. I'll let you be the choice. Who do you think would be involved in a vacuum sealer? That would be both people, because women like to do that and get their food out of the situation that says it's going to get a freezer burn. And then also the guy that's out there hunting, and there's women hunters, but for the most part, it's primarily men. They like to say to themselves, we want to make sure that our hunt, that our type of stuff that we went out and hunt and captured or killed, for our sustenance is not going to go to waste. We don't want to have all our hard-earned time out there that says, hey, we don't want to have this gone to waste. We want to be able to preserve it, if you know what I'm saying. We are into a situation now that is a no-brainer. We've got to go see this situation. And once you see it, you're going to say to yourself, definitely the men, okay? We're not talking about the garden hoses now, people. Here we go. We are talking about turkey fryers, and we're talking about Weber grills. Look at this. I got a good friend of mine. You are not going to outcook him. And look at, they've got his name. Smoky Joe. They ought to call that Smoky Dago Joe. Because let me tell you something. You're not going to outcook him on his compound. That much I guarantee. He's going to outcook you. He don't care what you got. You could give him an aluminum foil cooker that's made out of a makeshift aluminum foil. And you could even take this Weber right here with the flavor bars and everything. And I guarantee he's going to outcook you. Okay? You ain't going to make a better rump roast. You ain't going to make a better barbecue. You ain't going to make a better sausage. My friend Joe is going to outcook you. Okay? Let's just get that straight, number one. But anyway, they've got the bigger grills. They've got the barrel grills, 30-inch barrel grills. Okay? That's the ones I like right there. But you put a little propane action under that. This is for I think, the ones that have the charcoal grills or the briquettes. But I'm actually looking more for, how do I put this? For one that has propane. Now this one here, what's the Z grill? I've never seen this before. Oh, that's a pellet grill. That's a nice grill right there. I've never had the pellets, but with the pellet. But here's the old standby, tried and true, Kingsford. And if I'm right, I think I've seen some starters over here for propane, or excuse me, for the briquettes. Holy cow, people! Are you seeing that? I can remember just a few years back getting those for $199. Wow. Crescent is proud of their situation. I've got to get away from that. That's so expensive. But yeah, they've got the charcoal starters right here. I've actually got one of these. I wonder what they get for them. That's not too bad. I think I paid $19 or something years ago for one. I don't know about this one here. This looks like galvanized. I wouldn't want to put my stuff in there, but I've got a black one that's like a regular black steel. Huh. Now that's a little deal right there. A little mini torch. Little blue line mini torch. I wonder what fuels that. Let's see. I don't know. I ain't got my readers on. It must be some kind of lighter fluid or something. Now that's what I want for my garage right there. Come here. This is what I want. A little tin thing that says tailgating in progress. If you know what tailgating is all about, you know that's definitely a gender reveal that says. That's a man thing, people. And women love it too, but don't get me wrong. It's mainly priority of men. They want to tailgate. They want to do all them things. Now, if you're driving a car, that's a different story. That's more of a female thing where they tailgate, I think. I don't know. I've seen both people do it. But what else do we have here? Looks like, oh, wait a minute. Female thing right here. Hold on. We got to go check. Look at these cupolas. Look at that. How beautiful them are. I could take it or leave it, but that is pretty cool. I like the little awning on that one. Okay, I like the architectural structure of it. But primarily, we're talking about a female thing here, okay? And this is really going to... Now, this one here, the other one I just showed you, is it could be a female thing, it could be a man thing, because you've got shelter. You could put a transmission under there in a car and pull it out and be okay. But look at this one. Mama's not going to let you put your transmission or your four-wheel or anything under this one. You are definitely not getting her drapes and her screen room transmission fluid on it. That much I can promise you. But look how nice this is. You could really entertain some people under this thing. You could have a little smoker or a grill out here. Okay. Look at the size of that rooster. You wouldn't want that one chasing you in the yard. Guarantee. But, well, this is Bri. We've done the review. We've done the gender reveal at the Rural King. We've, how do I put it? We've made our way through, and it's almost time to close. I can see the eyes looking at me, and I can see the people saying, it's time to go. It's time to leave. It's time to check out. And we've got to get on down the road, people. This is Bri. I've got to go.